In this example, we are given that in the circuit shown in figure, the voltmeter is having a resistance of 4000 ohms. And here we are required to find the percentage error in the reading of this voltmeter. Here you can see that voltmeter is connected in parallel with the 1000 ohm resistance. That means here it is measuring the potential difference across 1000 ohm resistance. And as we are given a finite resistance of this voltmeter which is connected in parallel, so obviously it will draw some current, because after connecting this voltmeter, this 4000 ohm will be considered in parallel with this 1000 ohm. So in this situation, obviously due to the drawing of some current by the voltmeter, its reading will not at all be accurate. So if we calculate the current in circuit in absence of voltmeter, this can be given as I is equals to, as the EMF connected is 300 volt and only 500 and 1000 ohm resistance are connected in series. So total resistance will be 1500. So this will be 3 by 15 or it is 1 by 5, which can be taken as 0.2 ampere. This is the current in the circuit, and if we calculate the potential difference across 1000 ohm resistance in this situation, this potential difference, which is actually we are willing to measure by using the voltmeter, is IR. That will be 1 by 5 multiplied by 1000. So this 200 volt, which is the actual potential difference which we are willing to measure. Now, after connection of voltmeter, circuit resistance will become, because now voltmeter is connected in parallel with 1000 ohm, then the circuit resistance can be considered as 500 ohm resistance in series with 1000, and this voltmeter can be taken as an equivalent resistance of 4000 ohm, which is given in the problem. So it can be taken as 1000 in parallel with 4000 ohm. So this will be 1000 multiplied by 4000 divided by summation of these, which is 5000. So here you can see the value will be, in this situation, this 5, we can cancel. This will be 200. So this 800 plus 500, this is 1300 ohm. That is the total resistance of the circuit. So we can calculate the final current in circuit. Here can be written as I prime, which is equals to the EMF by resistance. It is 300 by 1300, which can be taken as 3 by 13 ampere. Now, if we calculate the potential difference across this 1000 ohm resistance, now we can see the potential difference across 1000 ohm is, if we can be written as I prime multiplied by the resistance of this 1000 ohm in parallel with 4000 ohm, because the total current I prime is flowing through the combination of these two. And this equivalent resistance will be 1000 multiplied by 4000 divided by 5000. So on calculation, you can see we are getting here the result is I prime is 3 by 13 multiplied by, in this situation, the equivalent resistance here will be 800 ohms. So this will be 800 ohms. So the result we are getting is 3 multiplied by 800 by 13. It is 2400 by 13 volt. This is the potential difference across this 1000 and 4000 ohm resistance. On calculation, this value is, finally we are getting 184.61 volt. As we have got the final potential difference across this 1000 ohm resistance, so this can be taken as a reading of voltmeter, which we can see that it is different from the actual value. And if we calculate the percentage error in reading, this can be directly given as the actual value is 200. Finally, we are getting is 184.61. So this can be written as 200 minus 184.61 divided by 200 multiplied by 100 in percent. So on calculation, after simplifying this, we are getting the result will be 7.69%. That will be the answer to this problem.